Good afternoon to my dear students. In the last class, we discussed about uniform circular motion. That is, if a particle is moving in a circular path, for example, this is center and this is radius. What we observe, what is uniform circular motion? It covers equal angular displacements in equal intervals of time. Means, here we consider angular displacement and a particle moving in circular path has angular velocity. As we know that here the speed of the particle remains constant, but velocity has been changing. Why? Because at each and every point, how to get the velocity? By drawing a tangent. So if you draw tangent at the point where we should know the direction of velocity, we get the velocity direction. So it is changing its direction, means what? The velocity is changing, means it is under acceleration due to acceleration, right? Not due to gravity, it is under acceleration. That acceleration should be always perpendicular, because the magnitude of speed remains constant, it should be towards the center, that is acceleration. So that acceleration is called what? Centripetal acceleration. So what is centripetal acceleration? When a particle is having uniform circular motion, the acceleration of the particle which is acting along the radius toward the center of the circular path is called centripetal acceleration. Means simply we can say that any particle moving in circular path, the acceleration of the particle is always directed towards the center. That acceleration is called what? Centripetal acceleration. Okay. So any particle moving, any particle, even the earth, you consider that earth is revolving in elliptical orbits around the sun. The earth is also experiencing the force. That force is called centripetal force, and the acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. Now we are going to find the expression for this centripetal acceleration. So what we are going to calculate here? Expression for centripetal acceleration. So for this, the particle need to be in circular path. Let us take a circular path which O is the center. Let us assume that the particle initially at point P1 and moves to a point P2 after some time t, in a time interval t. Okay. Now, what is the radius? This is r1 and this is r2, right? The shortest distance between initial point and final point, this is what? Delta r. The angular displacement is delta theta. So we consider uniform circular motion in that initially the particle is present at P1 and after some time t, it moves to a point P2. If you draw the radius vectors from O to P1 is equals to R1, O to P2 is R2. OP is equals to, sorry, OP1 is equals to R1 and OP2 is equals to what? R2. P1, P2 means the displacement is what? Delta R. That is equals to what, ma? R2 minus R1. Okay. Now, at this point, what is the velocity? This is the velocity, right? Let us assume that at this point, the velocity is 1, V1. And R2, the velocity is V2. Have you observed that? We draw a tangent, the velocity is perpendicular to R1. In the same way, V2 is also perpendicular to R2. So, what we observed here? V1 is perpendicular to R1. In a similar way, V2 is also perpendicular to R2. Is it right? Yes. So, if you take that vector direction, for example, this is V1 and this is V2. Now, so this is V1 and this is V2. From this triangle, this is delta v, right? Change in velocity A, B, C. And the angle also same, because both are perpendicular to each other, the angle subtended also same, that is what? Delta theta. Now we can say that OP1, P2 and ABC are, OP1, P2 and ABC are what, ma? Similar triangles. They are what? Similar triangles. See, R1, R2, R delta R. Angles are also same. And we can observe one more thing. From here to here, what is the distance? Radius. Means R1 is equals to R2 is equals to R. V1 is equals to V2 is equals to V. Sides are same. Here also sides are same. Angle subtended is same. So we can say that these two are similar triangles. According to law of similar triangles, delta V by V is equals to delta R by R. So this is the condition what we get from here. So see here, we consider a particle moving in uniform circular motion. Initially the particle is at P1. After some time t, it moves to a point P2. We have drawn radius vectors R1 and R2. The shortest distance between P1 and P2 is called what? Displacement. OP is equal to R1, OP2 is equal to R2. Delta R is equal to what, ma? R2 minus R1. Here, I want to know the velocity. Here, the velocity can be drawn by drawing a perpendicular, here also perpendicular. So, V1 is perpendicular to R1, V2 is also perpendicular to R2. And R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R, V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V. So, OP1, P2, I can write here if you have doubt that this is R1, R2, O, P, P1, delta R, theta, right? Sides are same, angles of subtended also same, right? Then that's why these two are called similar triangles. From the law of similar triangles, delta V by V is equal to what? Delta R by R. Okay. Now, what we have to calculate actually? Acceleration, right? Yes. So, acceleration at that point, that is called what? Instantaneous acceleration. What is instantaneous acceleration? A is equals to limit delta T tends to 0. Delta T tends to 0, delta V by delta T. Means at that instant of time, the change in velocity in a time interval T is called what? Acceleration. From equation 1, now only we derived what that? Delta V by V is equals to delta R by R. From this, delta V is equals to V by R into delta R. Am I right? Yes. Substitute this value here. A is equals to limit delta T tends to 0 V by R into delta R by delta T. That implies V is constant, R is constant here. Limit delta T tends to 0 delta R by delta T. As we know well that instantaneous velocity, what is instantaneous velocity? Velocity is equals to limit delta T tends to 0, change in displacement by time taken. So, I can replace this complete value with what? V, right? Yes. So, what you can write here? This acceleration is called centripetal acceleration. V by R into V, that is equals to what? V square by R. So, this is the formula for centripetal acceleration. Okay, as we know, if you want to write furthermore, we know that the relation between V and R, V and omega, V is equals to R omega, what you can write here? AC is equals to, what is V? R square omega square by R, RR cancel R omega square. In the last class we discussed, what is omega? The angle subtended by टाइम पीरियड 2π/T, सो इट कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट एज आर इंटू 2π2 4π2/T2। वन मोर फॉर्मूला इज वॉट, एफ इज इक्वल टू 1/T, सो आई कैन रीराइट दिस फॉर्मूला एज वॉट, ए सी इज इक्वल टू आर इंटू 4π2 F2। सो ऑल दीज आर द फॉर्मूलाज बेस्ड ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट. इफ दे गिव वी, वी कैन यूज दिस फॉर्मूला. इफ दे गिव इन ओमेगा, वी कैन यूज दिस फॉर्मूला. इफ इट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड टाइम पीरियड, द सेम कैन बी एनहांस्ड टू दीज फॉर्मूलाज. ओके, सो लेट अस सॉल्व सम 2-3 प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. सो विद दिस द चैप्टर विल कंप्लीट. क्लियर? यस. सो लेट अस हैव सम प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन सेंट्रिपेटल एक्सेलरेशन. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एन एयरक्राफ्ट एग्जीक्यूट्स ए हॉरिजॉन्टल लूप ऑफ रेडियस 1 किलोमीटर. सो व्हाट इज द रेडियस ऑफ द हॉरिजॉन्टल लूप? 1 किलोमीटर. मूविंग विथ ए स्टेडी स्पीड ऑफ 900 किलोमीटर पर आवर. कंपेयर सेंट्रिपेटल एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. सो दे सेड दैट देयर इज एन एयरक्राफ्ट एग्जीक्यूट्स ए हॉरिजॉन्टल लूप ऑफ हाउ मच? रेडियस 1 किलोमीटर. विथ ए स्टेडी स्पीड ऑफ 900 किलोमीटर पर आवर, वी हैव टू कंपेयर सेंट्रिपेटल एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. सो फर्स्ट गिवन, व्हाट आर द गिवन थिंग्स? वी शुड कन्वर्ट ऑल इनटू एस यूनिट्स. रेडियस इज इक्वल टू व्हाट मा? 1 किलोमीटर. दैट इज इक्वल टू 10^3 meters. स्पीड ऑफ एयरक्राफ्ट, व्हाट इज द स्पीड ऑफ एयरक्राफ्ट? वी इज इक्वल टू 900 into, we should convert into meter per second, right? So we should multiply with 5/18. 18 ones are 18, 5s. So 0 remains same. 5 into 5, 25. So total 250 meter per second. Now we have V, we have R. To compare, this is already known one. So we should compare with centripetal acceleration, right? Yes. Which formula we can take? AC is equals to V square by R, AC is equals to R omega square, AC is equals to R into 4π2 F2, R in this one. So we have V and R, so we can go for the basic formula. What is that? AC is equals to V square by R. What is V? 250 into 250 divided by 1000. So zeros cancel. Now 5 2s are 5 5s are. 25 into 5 is 125/2, 62.5 meter per second square. As we know, centripetal acceleration by acceleration due to gravity is g. So 62.5 by 9.8. So we get the answer as 6.38. This doesn't have a units because these two are having same values. So the units gets cancelled. This is the value what? Ratio. So this is a simple formula and simple question. We can easily calculate by using the direct formula. And the next one, next one is C. A stone tied to the end of a string of 80 centimeters. So a stone tied to the end of a string of 80 centimeters long is whirled, means we rotated in a horizontal circle with a constant speed. If the stone makes 14 revolutions in 25 seconds, what is the magnitude and direction of acceleration of the stone? So simple logic, take a, for example, this is the string. Okay, this is the string. Assume that this charger is stone. So connected to a string, what we'll do? We rotate. Yes. While we are playing, what we'll do? We will rotate the stone. Now it is forming what? Circular loop of length 80 centimeters and how many revolutions? 14 revolutions in 25 seconds. Means what? Frequency is given. Frequency is what? The number of revolutions made in 1 second. So given length of the string is equal to how much? 80 centimeters. We should convert into meters. That is equal to what? Divide by 100. If you do that, 0.8 meters. frequency with what frequency we are rotating? 14 revolutions in 25 seconds. And next, it is moving with constant speed. Okay, so it is making in circular loop. So since it is moving in circular path, it has centripetal acceleration. AC is equals to V square by R, but we cannot use that formula. Here length is nothing but what? For example, you are making the loop, this is the length of the rod, that is equals to what? Radius. So the length can be taken as what? Radius. But we don't know V, so we can go for other formula. What are the other formulas we have? So in terms of frequency, this formula you can use, right? AC is equals to R into 4 pi square F square. So I am going to use the same formula, that is equals to what? R into 4 pi square F square. Substitute the values, just AC is equals to R 0.8, 4 into 3.14 whole square into 14 by 25 whole square. Calculating all this, we get the answer as 9.9 meter per second square. So one more thing they has in the question, what is that? What is the magnitude we calculated? That is 9.9 meter per second square. And what is the direction? Any particle moving in circular path is under centripetal acceleration. It is always directed towards the center. So at every point, we should write this one, otherwise we will lose the one mark. At every point, the acceleration is where? Along the radius and towards the center of, towards center of circular path. Okay, at every point the acceleration is along the radius and toward the center of circular path. Clear? Yes. The last question of this chapter. So with this question, the chapter is going to complete. A cyclist is riding with a speed of 27 km per hour. As he approaches a circular turn, on the road, what he will do? Of radius 80 meters, he applies brakes and reduces speed at a constant rate of 0.5 meter per second square. What is the magnitude and direction of the net acceleration of the cyclist on circular track? So this is what we observed in everyday life, right? When you are moving in circular path, what we will do? When a circular turn comes, we reduce our speed. Here all the same thing has done. What is the speed of the cyclist initially here? Speed of cyclist, how much ma? 27 km per hour. That is V is equals to, we should convert into meter per second, 5 by 18. 9 2s are 9, 3s are. So how much? 7.5 meter per second. He applied translatory acceleration, not centripetal. How much? 0.5 meter per second square. So for example, he is moving in this direction on the circular turn. What he has done? He applied acceleration. So this is centripetal acceleration and this is translatory acceleration, because he applied brake means acceleration is acting in opposite direction. So now AC and AT are perpendicular to each other. This is the resultant. Okay, let us calculate AC first. What is AC? V square by R. As they already mentioned that the radius of the circular path is how much? 80 meters. So V, 7.5 whole square by 80. If you calculate, you get 0.7 meter per second square. So the cyclist is moving in circular path. Centripetal acceleration is acting toward the center, that is 0.7 meter per second square, and he applied brakes. The acceleration of the brakes is how much? 0.5 मीटर पर सेकंड स्क्वायर, बोथ आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर, सो ए इज इक्वल रूट ऑफ ए सी स्क्वायर प्लस ए टी स्क्वायर प्लस 2 AC AT cos 90. When two vectors are acting at an angle, the resultant is what? R equals to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Here what is A? AC. What is B? AT. Angle how much? 90. So cos 90 is 0. This total term becomes 0. Root of AC square 0.7 whole square plus 0.5 whole square. That equals to 0.86 meter per second square. For example, if theta is the angle made by this vector, then tan theta is equals to, sorry, angle will be always with respect to the horizontal. So this is theta, means this is AC and this is AT, this is resultant, this is the angle. Okay, tan theta is equals to opposite side by adjacent side, AC by AT, that is equals to 1.4. If you calculate this is value, you get theta is equals to 54 degrees 27 minutes. So this is the magnitude and direction of the acceleration a particle moving in circular path. Thank you. So with this problem, the chapter has been completed. In the next class, we are going to start the next chapter, Newton's laws of motion. Thank you, students.